Hello friends, here is the chat app which I created in my previous video. Now in this app I can write any post and send it using this button. Okay, so in my previous video I showed you how to add widgets for these posts. Now in this video I'll show you how to add comments for these posts. So this is the chat app and this is the page on which I can write anything and send them as posts. So these are stored in the path chat underscore path, and here it contains the post ID for each post. These are the post IDs, and each post ID has these keys: text, time, username, and some of them has the key widgets. Now here only I will add the key comments, and inside that I will add all these keys again. So I will have to make a reference to the post ID. So I will just go to Sketchware, and here I have this page post underscore data.xml which contains this text view for displaying the post, and for this is for displaying the widgets. Now below this I will add a list view for displaying comments, and below this a linear. Inside this I will add edit text and a button. For edit text I will set weight equal to 1, and for list view also I will set weight equal to 1. Now for this list view I will select custom view as the same custom view which I used in chat.xml. This is custom.xml, and this contains these three text views: text view 1, text view 2, and text underscore time. And this linear 2 has two text views for displaying widgets, and I have this image view 1. So I will make image view 1 gone and linear 2 gone because I will not be using these, and I will use the rest of the three text views. Now in chat.xml I send the data using these keys. The key username contains the Firebase auth UID, key text contains edit text 1 get text, and key time contains calendar now get time. And while retrieving data I retrieve all the post IDs in this key, in this list string keys. Okay, here I have this list string keys, and you can use the code which I used in my previous video, or a simple way is use on child added event. So suppose you are using chat on child added event, then you can use these blocks: Firebase DB get children, chat get children to list map all chats, and inside this add child key to list string keys. Okay, so this will add all the post ID to this list string keys. So when user clicks on any of the items, that is list view 1 on item clicked, here I will set the screen to post data activity. Then I will add this extra key post ID as get at position of list string keys, and I will put extra key post as get value at position key text of list map all chats. So I will carry these two data to the post data activity using this intent put extra key. Now in post data activity, which is post.xml, here I've already added these list view, edit text 1, and button 1. So here I have to add a Firebase DB component for comments. I will add this component comments will file path with data location comments. Then I will add a Firebase auth component fauth also for getting the Firebase auth UID of user. Then I will add a calendar component cal and a calendar component now. Okay, now here is the important part. In the on activity create event, I will make this Firebase DB comments stop listening. Then I will create a new string variable called comment path, comment underscore path. This will be the path to which I will make reference. So I will set this string comments underscore path to chat underscore path slash join activity get extra key post ID and slash comments. So this will be the path, and I will make reference to this using this code. I'll just copy this, then use another add so stackly block, and here I will make the Firebase DB component comments is equal to underscore firebase dot get reference, and I will make reference to comment path, comment underscore path, and after this I will use Firebase DB start listening. Comments start listening. So this is in on create event. Now when user clicks on button 1, here I will be using the same blocks which I used in chat activity. So I'll just copy this to collection and paste it in post data activity. Okay, so here if length of edit text 1 is more than 0, then I will set calendar now as get now, then create new map, put key username value firebase auth get UID, put key text value edit text 1 get text and time value calendar now get time. Then I push it to Firebase DB component comments, and for edit text I set text as empty after sending the data. After sending the data, next event will be on child added event for comments, comments on child added. In this event, I will use this simple block Firebase DB comments get children to list map. Here we need a list map, map list. So I will get all the children to map list, and then I will display this map list in custom view, custom list view. So here I will use list view 1 set list custom list view data map list and list view 1 refresh data. Now after this, next event will be on bind custom view, list view 1 on bind custom view. Here I will make image view 1 set visible gone, and I will not be using linear 2 also, so I will make linear 2 set visible gone, and then I will use this if then block, if list map map list contains at position key username, which contains the key username, then for text view 1 I will set the key, set the text as get value at position key username of list map map list. So this will display the user ID of user in text view 1, user who has sent the post. Next I will use similar code, if the list map map list contains the key text, then I display the key text of list map map list in text view, text view 2. Now for displaying the time, I'll use the same block which I used in chat activity. Here in onbind custom view I had these blocks for displaying the time, so I'll just copy this And in post data activity, I will use this. If map list contains the key time, then I set calendar component to get the key time at position of list map map list. Then I set the calendar component now to get now. I get the difference between now and cal. And if it is more than 1000 into 3600 into 24, means if it is more than 1 day, then I set the text of text view text underscore time as calendar cal format DDMMMYY. Otherwise, I set the text as calendar cal format HHMMSS, means hour, minute, second, if it is less than 1 day. Now, that's all in coding part. Okay, so here, if I click on where and you, it should be where are you. So here, if I write anything like Agra and click on this send button, this will appear as a comment along with my user ID and time. If I add something else, like Nagpur, it will appear here. So in this way, we can add comments. Now let's see another post. Yeah, this will not display the comments which we sent on other page. So these are comments exclusive to this post, and our other post contains comments exclusive to that post. So in this way, we can add comments to posts in Firebase app. I hope this was useful. Thank you very much for watching this.